I realize my life has been incredibly confusing over the past few weeks. So here's a quick summary for all of you so you can still understand what is going on. I mean, it's hard enough to get what is going on as we live through it, but how are you supposed to understand exactly? So you know that I was living in Al's flat in London for a while. He was mostly gone to take care of his friend Bunbury and also did some businessy things. Occasionally he would still drop by and visit me and we would just hang out and have fun. Turns out now he only invented Mr. Bunbury. Yeah, invented! Can you believe that? Just so he would have an excuse whenever there was some sort of social event or other sort of responsibility he wanted to avoid. It was all like, oh, I'm sorry dear Augusta Pracknell, I can't make it to dinner tonight. I need to take care of my poor old friend Mr. Bunbury who needs me so very much. Huh? I mean, what a genius. I wish I had that idea. I'm a bit mad he never let me take advantage of it. I'm his oldest friend, what was he thinking? I wanted to ditch dinners. I wanted to ditch my mom. Apparently, when he said he visited Mr. Bunbury, he in fact was spying a little on Ernest, Jack, on Jack and Cecily, and he visited Hertfordshire secretly sometimes. Jack forgot an engraved business card case at Algernon's place at one point, and it read, "To my dear Jack, from little Cecily, XOXO." And then, oh, do I really need to explain this? You all know Al by now. Well, alright, I'm doing him injustice now. At that point, he was still like the sweet older brother I never had. He was just afraid Jack was like double dating behind my back and would break my heart. So he investigated the whole thing. Aww, Al can be such a sweetheart sometimes. He really is always there for me. Unless he leaves me behind and hides behind the stupid excuse of Mr. Bunbury. Never mind, I'm still angry at you, Al. Okay, anyway. Al found out that Cecily wasn't really competition for me since Jack just saw her basically like a younger sister and they just lived together. And then Al did what he always does. He set it to his mind to seduce Cecily. Especially since he Facebook stalked her before, like the pervert he is. She's just his type, you know? Cute, naive, blonde. He knew about the lies Jack told Cecily in his prison. He also knew if he would just go there and visit Cecily when Jack wasn't around, he could easily pretend to be that super mega badass brother Ernest that Cecily would totally fall for. So he did. He came over just when I got my tattoo, and then he whisked off Cecily to that small vacation. So we kept on missing each other until that dreadful day when we all found out there wasn't any Ernest to begin with. Can you still follow? Yeah, me neither. Jack. Ernest. So actually, Ernest did the same thing that Elle did with Bunbury, just with Ernest, and then the other way around. Let's try that again. Okay, again. Jack Worthing is Cecily's flatmate, and he just pretended he had a very indecent younger brother called Ernest. Yeah. Jack came home the other day to tell Cecily that his brother Ernest had died to get rid of all the lies, finally. Only that was messed up by Al being here pretending to be Ernest. Because, you know, you can't be dead and seduce someone at the same time. I came over here because I wanted to rebel against my mom and be with Ernest, only to find out he never existed. And that I've been in love with a man with the horrible plain name of Jack. And now everyone is upset with each other, except for Jezebel and Miss Prism, who somehow seem to hit it off. It's super awkward. Yep. Well, that's it for this week. I guess I will stop now and look for some tattoo removal services.
This was a Darjeeling.